Here we are on the kitchen porch. We have our mason bee, solitary bee nesting boxes. And we're gonna check out the action today. The top box has three holes filled already. Three holes filled with mud. We have people going in and out there. The bottom box has a couple of bees going in and out, but nobody's filled anything yet with mud and eggs and larvae and things. So the middle box is where a lot of the action is going on here. I'm going to zoom in so that you can watch for a minute. You can see it's got about 15 tubes already filled with eggs. Now there's somebody interested in that bottom box. See? That blue mason bee really likes that hole there. And here we have where most of the tubes have been filled so far. And hopefully somebody will be coming in any second now. Here comes somebody. They're all buzzing around. And we have the two species that are nesting in here. The little fuzzy brown Osmia taurus. And then we have the big blue-black blue orchard mason bees, the Osmia lignaria. And they seem to be coexisting, and they don't seem to mind nesting together. Awfully nice seeing them buzzing in and out in the sun, especially when you're sitting and eating at the little porch table here. Because they don't sting, and it's just nice to sit in the sun and have little bees buzzing around nearby. It's a comforting sound. Just something really nice about seeing these little bees happily making their nests. Usually they'd be making nests in the wild in big old rotting trees and rotting logs or crumbling stone walls and things, but you know, there aren't that many big rotting trees and rotting logs anymore because everybody keeps cleaning them up right away. So they're actually eliminating a lot of good habitat for the native bees by doing that. Sometimes they go into one hole and then realize it's the wrong one. And they come out right away again and try again. Anyway, it's really nice to see them. And you can see all of these filled holes right now. There's quite a lot of them. They're all a little bit smaller than the honeybees, but you know their buzz is just as loud, which is kind of surprising. Right on cue, somebody comes buzzing right by me here. Okay. And there's somebody up there. Oh no, they're trying to get back down here again. They're having a great time. Nice, sunny, warm day. And that's, I think there's about 24 tubes filled with mud at this point. Well, not filled with mud, filled with the little chambers. Each chamber has a little loaf of bee bread, which is pollen, and a little egg attached to it. And then they seal that with mud and go on to the next chamber and build a whole series in the tube. And then when the tube is filled and sealed with mud, they start on the next tube. Each tube has maybe five or six chambers with eggs in them. Okay, so that's all for today.